AOTInductor, or ahead of time inductor, exports your PyTorch models so you can easily deploy them as compiled C++, which is an improvement over Python if you're looking for lower latency, lower memory footprint, fewer runtime dependencies, or better security. As the name implies, AOTInductor compiles before runtime. It uses torch.export to create a static computational graph for the model, and then uses TorchInductor to compile the graph into an optimized deployable artifact for inference. Let's get started with it on Intel GPUs, which it now supports with PyTorch 2.7. Intel CPUs were already supported. This PyTorch documentation page has everything you need to install and get started with PyTorch on Intel GPUs. And I'll just use the simple PyTorch example, which defines a trivial model so we can focus on deployment. I'm using an Intel Data Center Max Series GPU, but this will also work on Intel Arc or integrated Intel Core Ultra GPUs. And I already created the AOTI example directory and files from the example, and I've installed the XPU version of PyTorch. XPU is the designation for Intel GPUs. We use Python to define the trivial model, along with how to deploy it using AOTInductor. First, we set our device, and I added a print line to verify. Then we send the model to that device. Here, we're defining the first dimension of the input as a dynamic shape. Remember, this creates a static graph, so we bound its range. Then we have our call to AOTInductor compile and package, passing in the exported model, and it will compile the model as a shared library with this file name. And we will pair that model with some simple inference code in C++, which loads in the model, defines inputs to it, and sends them to the Intel GPU, and runs inference with a couple batch sizes along that dynamic dimension. Then we have our CMakeLists file for configuring the build across platforms. This project will require and try to find the Torch shared library. It's going to build an executable from the compiled inference and model code, and here, it's specifying how to generate the compiled model using the Python code. Let's create a build directory one level down from those files. And first, we will configure the project, pointing it to PyTorch's CMake packages to generate the system build files using what we just created in the directory above. Then we build the project using those build files. Here you see the output for my print statement, so it's running the Python code to capture the computational graph and generating the C++, compiling it along with the inference C++, and linking those objects into an executable. This whole process took about 40 seconds, so let's jump ahead. Now we can run inference using the compiled executable. Again, simple example, but you can adapt it for your model and needs. I'll put the links to the documentation for getting started with PyTorch on Intel GPUs, as well as the AOTInductor example, in the description below.